गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8, सब्जेक्ट साइंस। वी वर स्टडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 12, दैट इज फ्रिक्शन। इट्स योर लेक्चर नंबर 2। टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड इन दिस लेक्चर आर, फर्स्ट इज फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स, सेकेंड इज कॉज ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, मीन्स हाउ द फ्रिक्शन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड, ओके। नेक्स्ट फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग फ्रिक्शन एंड टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कवर दीज फोर टॉपिक्स। So students, you might have seen a driver of a car or a truck slowing down the vehicle at a traffic signal, right? And you also slow down your bicycle whenever needed by applying brakes. So have you ever thought why a vehicle slows down when brakes are applied? And not only the vehicles, any object which is moving over the surface of another object slows down when no external force is applied on it, right? If no external force is applied on the object, then it slows down. This is the fact. So have you ever thought that why do we slip when we step on a banana peel? And similarly, why is it difficult to walk on a smooth and wet floor? So the answer to all these questions is related to friction. Okay? The answer to all these questions is related to friction. So let's know about friction. Let's study about the friction. So what is friction or frictional force? Friction can be defined as the force that opposes the motion of an object. Means friction is a force that opposes the motion of an object or prevent the object to be moving. And this frictional force always arises due to contact between two surfaces. Okay, it always arises due to contact between two surfaces. Let's consider an example. As we know, a ball stops after covering some distance, and it stops because the motion of the ball is opposed by the force of friction. Okay, the motion of the ball is opposed by the force of friction, which is exerted by the ground on the ball. It means a ball stops because of frictional force which is exerted by the ground on the ball, as shown in this picture. One more important point about friction is it always acts in a direction opposite to a moving object. Okay, friction always acts in a direction opposite to a moving object and tends to stop it from moving, means it prevents the object from moving. For example, if you push the box towards right direction, then the frictional force, the force of friction, acts in the left direction. Okay, means the frictional force always acts in a direction opposite to a moving object, or opposing. Now we will talk about an interesting phenomena related to friction. So we all know that in winters, when we rub our hands get warm. Means we often rub our hands together to warm them. But why it happens? It happens because of friction. Friction is caused by rubbing your hands together, which produces heat. Okay? Friction caused by rubbing your hands together, which produces heat. Thus, we can conclude that friction is a force that opposes motion. And second thing is, friction is a force that produces heat. Okay? Friction is a force that opposes motion and produces heat. Okay, so this is all about friction. Now the question is, how the friction is introduced? What is the cause of friction? So friction is caused by the irregularities on the two surfaces in contact. No surface is completely smooth. Even the surface which is appear to be very smooth has some minute irregularities. So friction is caused by the irregularities on the two surfaces in contact. Factors on which force of friction depends. Now I am going to explain that what are the factors on which force of friction depends. So the first factor is nature of surface. Okay. First factor is nature of surface. Friction is very less between two smooth surfaces. Means if the surfaces are smooth, then friction is very less. And if the surfaces are rough, then friction is more. Means friction is more between two rough surfaces. And for proving this, already done the activities in the previous lecture, right? And the second factor is weight of the body. How the force of friction depends on weight of the body? How the frictional force depends on weight of the body? So the force of friction is directly proportional to weight of the body which moves. Directly proportional means if weight of the body increases, then force of friction also increases. Okay, means if weight increases, then force of friction also increases. So the force of friction is directly proportional to the weight of the body which moves. These are the two factors on which frictional force depends. And remember one thing, the force of friction does not depend upon the area of surface. Okay. Now our next topic is types of friction. And we will study the various types of friction. Friction is of three types as shown in the flow chart. First is static friction, second is sliding friction, and third is rolling friction. Okay, there are three types of friction. First is static friction, second is sliding friction, and third is rolling friction. So let us know about these three types of friction one by one. So what is static friction? Static friction exists between those two bodies which are relatively at rest. Even though an external force is acting on them. Means we apply the force on two bodies. And even after applying force, the two bodies remains at rest. Okay, and This happens because of static friction. The force required to overcome friction at the instant an object starts moving from rest means initially the object is at rest, and at the instant when the object starts moving, some force is required to overcome friction. And the amount of force which is required to overcome friction is a measure of static friction. Okay. For example, we all know that it's not easier to move a heavy box from one place to another place. When you apply force to move a heavy box, a force is required, right? A force is required to overcome friction so that it can start moving from rest. And the maximum force of friction that can be generated between two static surfaces. Okay, the force of friction generated between two static surfaces means these two surfaces are at rest. And this force of friction which is generated between two static surfaces is called static friction. Okay, so this is all about static friction. Next type of friction is sliding friction. Now, what is sliding friction? It is the opposing force that comes into play when one body slides over the surface of another body. Means this sliding friction comes into play when one body slides over the surface of another body. And this sliding friction is slightly smaller than the static friction. We have already learned about the static friction. And if we compare these two types of friction, then remember this. The sliding friction is slightly smaller than the static friction. Sliding friction is always smaller than the static friction. That's why, because of this reason, it is easier to move the box which is already in motion, right? On the other hand, we can also say the force required to keep the object moving with the same speed is a measure of sliding friction. It means the force needed to keep the object moving with the same speed is a measure of sliding friction. Okay, so this is all about sliding friction. Next type of friction is rolling friction. The opposing force which comes into play when one body rolls over the surface of another body. Means this type of frictional force or this opposing force comes into play when one body rolls over the surface of another body. For example, roller skates have wheels that help in moving very fast. The wheels of the skate experience rolling friction while moving. Means in between the wheels and the surface of ground, there is a rolling friction. And always remember that rolling friction is always less than sliding friction. Okay, rolling friction is always less than sliding friction. Now our next topic is fluid friction. But first of all, what are fluids? Liquids and gases are called fluids. Like water and air, they are fluids. And all fluids exerts a force of friction on objects that move through them. Okay. All fluids exerts a force of friction on objects that move through them. And this force of friction exerted by fluids is called fluid friction. It means we can say the fluid friction is nothing but a force of friction exerted by fluids. The frictional force exerted by fluids is also called drag. Means it is the another name of fluid friction. Okay. And this fluid friction is also called drag. The frictional force on an object depends on shape, material, and speed of the object moving through them. Means this fluid friction depends on shape, material, and speed of the object moving through them. For example, the objects that have a streamlined shape experience lesser friction, and it is for this reason that boats, ships, and aeroplanes are streamlined. The streamlined shape minimizes this fluid friction. Aeroplanes, rockets, and missiles have a streamlined shape to move in the air easily. Because of this shape, they can move in the air easily. So students, this is your homework. Question number one is, what is friction? Means you have to define what is friction. Second question is, on what factors does friction depend? Third question is, why is friction more on a rough surface as compared to a smooth surface? As we all know that friction is more on a rough surface and less on a smooth surface. Now you have to write the reason then why it is more on a rough surface and less on a smooth surface. Question number 4 is, explain the 3 types of friction like static friction, sliding friction, and rolling friction. You have to explain these type of friction. Question number 5 is, explain the cause of friction. Give an example. Next question is, what type of shape do boats and ships have? Means you have to write that what type of shape do boats and ships have. Right answer only in one word. Okay. And do these questions in your FAIR notebook. So this ends for today's lecture. Thank you.